is a great women achiever. Thank you everyone, and welcome Ms. Lokhande.
Thank you for a brilliant introduction. Hello everybody, and happy Women's Day to all who are present here. And I thank Exchange for Media for giving me an opportunity. This is the first time that I'm going to present something, so pardon me if I make any mistakes. And a tricky topic on which I think the industry is rumbling since last more than a decade, attempting various things. And I need not say if measurement is possible or impossible or practical, because almost all the sessions you have heard that measurement is possible. And Haresh has presented, everybody is Binku has spoken on how they are measuring their campaigns, what are they doing, how are they using data. And you know, this complete era where internet users are growing day by day and smartphone users are growing, 50% of the global population is on smartphone. India alone has 330 million users. Data available through the mobile from the smartphone users is immensely rich as of now. So I go by saying that yes, it is possible, definitely possible in this era where digital is growing. I don't want to rumble on a lot of figures or anything, because people have spoken a lot on data by now, right? Everybody has said that how they're leveraging data, tech, every agency has their own tool, we have our own tool. Everybody is leveraging data to give measurement in their own ways to the client to help them achieve their business objectives. We came across a BCG study, which was released in December 2018, which says future of Indian media house, which says that this data that is available actually tells us that you can talk to the consumer at 1 trillion touch points. 1 trillion touch points. That's a huge number, right? And if I were to throw some numbers, and somebody said that a consumer looks at his mobile 2.5 minutes every time he looks at his mobile, right? So average 80 times a day, consuming almost 3.5 hours of time every day on the mobile, and he's 70% out of home, 60 to 70%, right? What does that tell you? That tells you that out of home has a prowess of contextually connecting these audiences who are continuously on move. And how do we use? So the current session told us that what digital media is giving us, and digital media can throw you this data and it can tell you whether who saw the ad and all. Similarly, pairing digital media actually is showing that out of home investment shows improvement in performance. And how? There are many studies behind that. But I don't know if you have heard the word commuter commerce, right, which has been increasingly used in US and UK. This throws the data of all audiences who are commuting, and how are they really using their mobile phones. If we know that the kind of data, the gender, the demographics, everything that we get, we can actually use it for effective planning. We can actually better the ROI. You know, I remember somebody telling here that agar hum aag band karke gaadi chalayenge to hamara accident ho jayega. There's a science behind it. And last year, whoever has attended Exchange for Media, Stuart was here from UK, from Kinetic UK, speaking about seduction and sunlight, right? It's a report by Tim Spencer which says that why does a consumer has propensity to look at out of home? It's because there's a lot of science behind it. We are hardwired individuals. When you go out in the sun, the vitamin D element gets activated through the sunlight, and there is an enzyme that develops in our brain because of which you are alert to everything that happens outside. And because you're alert, your receptivity goes high. So, and of course, out of home is large. Nobody can deny that. That's the only medium which has a great size. And yeah, through mobile, you can actually ask consumers to take action. Few studies, few reports, like Jayesh mentioned that in US it shows 4x. Some reports shows that out of home actually can drive 3x CTR, which is huge. and we have witnessed it in some of the campaigns that we have done in India, right? We've also seen that mobile is becoming the linchpin by all the brand people, and they're seeing that how they can do everything and connect it to mobile, because the audience is always connected on that mobile. And what is this mobile data doing? It is actually unlocking the measurability potential against the client's business outcomes. You can find out how many number of people visited the stores. You can find out whether they really went on the video, they saw the video, if they are paired, if it's synced. Vinku just gave an example of how when you sync the digital video to the mobile video, how does the CTR jumps. You can retarget. Now, the kind of data that we have, the richer data that we have, you actually know these audience IDs. You can track them a month long or more after your campaign is over. You can retarget them. You can find out their habits. You know what they buy. You know what they don't buy. You know whether they visit a mall. You even know, in fact, the commuter commerce study says that 14% of online sales comes from consumer who's commuting. And it's not fashion or retail alone. It is including tourism. It is including your finances. It is including your insurance and just about everything, beauty, hygiene, name it. Right, and one of the reports also say that 70% of the audience say, who are doing the commuting commerce, say that they have bought after seeing the ad when they were outside. Now, nothing else can vouch more saying that out of home works, and yes, there is measurement there. So I will quickly take you through three case studies. One which will show you that how with real-time data we can incorporate tech and make out-of-home smarter. One where we show how out-of-home can drive footfalls. And one which shows that how engagement can be driven. This is one study from United Airlines, where they wanted to prove which airport is nearer. So United Airlines flies out of Newark airport in US. But people generally know that if you're talking New York, it means JFK, right? So they wanted to prove that no, but Newark is easier to commute, faster to reach, okay, and the traffic is also lesser. So what they did, they took the real-time data, they used the taxi tops because that's where they find their audience. And if you see, that's a tech that is developed, which shows whenever the taxi is traveling in whichever areas, it shows what is the time from here to Newark versus JFK. 11% lift in consideration for United Airlines. That's brilliant. I did not speak about any other data point of CTR or anything like that. One more campaign which we tested in India, right? We wanted to see footfalls to the store. 30% due to out-of-home and 64% when out-of-home was combined with mobile, which means everything is geo-fenced. Only the audience which is related to the brand has been targeted, retargeted. And that audience has now gone to the footfall because, and this is all attributable data. It is nothing that is a hypothesis, which all of us were relying on so many years. Dell Spiderman, digital out of home, which has driven engagement, providing a complete gamifying experience, right? Where you can actually go play, make the Spiderman climb up the wall using the Times Square digital screens and all. And it shows that how many people have seen and how many people have actually played the games over there. So it is all measurable, all data that is measurable, available for the brand, easy. And in India, more easily available. We know partners who have 200 million user data of PIN codes, all PIN codes of India, more than 19,200 PIN codes, right? So that can be used. And the data available to the granularity of demography, app usage inside the mobile, and all these people are GDPR compliant, right? But when I was given the topic measurement, while we do a lot of measurement, and because we do not have any other methods, we use mobile data to find out what is measurement, I thought, let me take it a bit more seriously. And instead of showing only what we do, only how we approach, let's go to Google and find out what does it mean. Created a word cloud, quantification is the biggest meaning. Quantification is the biggest meaning. So I said, okay, are we really quantifying? What are we doing? And what did our big brothers do? What did the TV do? What did the digital do? Right? When they came in, and how did they bring in measurement? mind it, they did not jump to measurement. They did not. They realized they need measurement. Digital realized they need measurement. TV realized they need measurement. In 1994, when they realized, TV realized that they need measurement because they are not able to, the satellite channels are not able to find out where are my consumers going, why, how can I get more advertisers. They first came on AdX. They first came on measuring the size of their industry, because of which they got to know what is the competition doing, who's giving ad to which channel, how can I leverage, what is it that I can build. Right now, everything of this is happening in silos, but TV does it in a unified manner. When you know what you are doing, how you are delivering, which is the hygiene, and when you know what are you doing, what is your competition doing, which you can obviously tell the advertiser, then they found that, okay, now there is a measurement which is not only measuring my campaign, but is also throwing a comparative to my competition, which is more sustained. Now, if a racket knows what is a Unilever doing on a similar brand, that helps them more strategize, right? Digital, struggling with measurement, talking about everybody having a different module, everybody releasing the data. September 2018, digital got into AdX. TAM is working on AdX, one software where all data of print, radio, TV, digital gets inside, throws a comparative. So they are making the base for their industry, which throws a non-debatable base of the industry. What is our industry size? Can anybody throw up a number? Pardon? 6,000 to 8,000. 4,000 crores. Three numbers or more floating in the market. Pitch Madison says 3,300 crore. TYNY says another number. KPMG says 3,700 crore. And IOAA says 4,400 crore. Nobody is ready to wait it because we do not know how it is collected. Somebody said 6,000 crore, possibly, if we start measuring it. What we need to know is, are we measuring our industry? That's critical. Because now if you know the size of your industry, you can go and fight for your pie. You're not able to do that because we are fighting as individuals. Agencies are fighting as individuals to take their share. Media owners are fighting individuals to saying, ki, why are you taking this site? Why don't you take my hoarding? Right? We are talking of rate rationalization. We are talking of driving ROIs and everything. Even if we come on the right industry size, we will be pretty sorted. And hence, the question that was raised on the first panel, that are we really growing? And while we were 6% 3 years back, we were actually 7.9%, which is close to 8% a decade back. And we are actually going to 5.4%, or some report might say 5%. So that you can discard. But we are declining share, because while other people are growing, we are not growing. We are growing, but we are not growing to an extent to make a dent in the pie. We are not doing that. Why? Because while some clients believe in out-of-home because they see results at their end, which they do not share, while we see all these things, we still lack part of credibility. We are last of the food chain, which is absolutely right. We get cut first when the budget gets cut, because we do not have a number to share. In fact, you should know, the BCG report that I mentioned, which said future of Indian media house, December 2018, does not have out of home in it. The future of Indian media house report, which is with Confederation Indian Industry, does not have out of home in it. That is the state of our industry today. When we all are saying that industry is growing, 11%, 12%, 15%, double digit growth, everything, transit is growing, and it is growing. Not that it is not growing, but they don't find us credible enough to incorporate in the future of Indian Media House report. So, and while I was discussing with few people why did this happen, or how can we change this? They said, ki, अरे इंडस्ट्री का साइज ही मालूम नहीं है एग्जैक्टली गिनने जाओगे तो ज्यादा ही होगा सो कैन वी लाइक विंकू सेड द बेड रॉक हैज टू बी लेड फर्स्ट सो कैन एंड हियर व्हेन आई से वी नीड टू मेजर द इंडस्ट्री फर्स्ट वी डू नॉट हैव टू हैव एनी फियर IOAA इज आस्किंग एवरीबडी टू सेंड हु सेंट यू लेट परचेस ऑर्डर्स हु सेंट यू लेट पेमेंट्स प्लीज गिव मी द डेटा देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ फियर एट दैट टाइम there is a fear of isolation, fear of not getting the later POs, fear of not getting payments, fear of getting banned from entering the agency offices. You know, people fearing, saying that, I was present in one of the meeting, my first meeting, and they said that nahi, when phone karke bolta hai tumhara buyer ki ye mat karo, tumko humse kuch ye problem hai kya karke. For addicts, there is no such fear. For creating an addict, there is no such fear. All you have to give is all the campaigns that you run. Give a standard rate card, industry gets measured. Everybody comes together. You don't need to know what you give a Madison or what you give a Postoscope or what you give a Kinetic. This is the only industry that doesn't have rate card. The ITC media head who was here made a statement ki kind of on the credibility lines, which said that you are commoditized. You guys undercut rates. This is the word that he used. First time I heard a client using that, I'm extremely happy because of that. You guys undercut rate. We devalue our own medium. So we have no right to say that give us all the credibility. If we stop devaluing our own medium, if we start measuring our industry first, we can all come on a consensus on measurement, unified pricing, and everything. But the first step has to be addicts. Addicts will bring in a lot of transparency. Addicts will give rate card to our industry. Addicts will also give monetization mechanism, because advertisers or brands, agencies will also start subscribing to this addicts. And with this monies, you can now go ahead and even conduct researches on industry behalf. Right now, we are fighting. We are all working on measurement in IOAA, but we are all fighting ki vendor itna paisa dega kya? Main ek taka vendor ke PO mein se kaatega, to vendor agree karega kya? Then there are silo conversation which says, arre, tum IOA ke member se leke aao, hoga hi nahi. Let's cut all the conversations. Let's just come on developing the addicts, where you have no fear of you not getting a PO or a payment, where we have no fear of anything. Just let's come on addicts. You develop an addicts, you will build credibility to the medium. It's our job to build credibility to the medium. With this, I would say, let's change practices which makes that measurement is impossible.
So wonderful. Well, thank you so much, ma'am, here. And now I would like to call upon stage Mr. Amit Satya, Head Marketing Cisco Group, to kindly give the memento to the dynamic lady here. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a round of applause for this beautiful and yet very impactful lady, Miss Rachana Lokhande. Please put your hands together louder, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.